会着。
Shalashyarwa.
With a healthy supply of food, the village could start to grow. To do so, it would need more hands to share the work.
Fara.
Wait,
yeah.
Mate.
Dende. Gadriende. Yeah, yeah. Meta. Huh? Meta. Quetta.
The new workforce could now turn to the growing village's needs. First, they would build a mill near their food source, so villagers could drop off gathered berries more easily.
Willer. Work end day.
Next, the growing village would need wood to build with.
Yaru. Wudu. Abendende.
Here's this. Yar Hueta.
Hueta? Yeah, yeah. Ichipara. Huende.
The growing community now had a steady supply of lumber. To make wood collection easier, villagers could erect a lumber camp near the forest.
Gongende! Workende!
Thanks to the camp, villagers no longer needed to travel as far to drop off lumber. The village now required additional houses to support its growing population.
Here, Werta. Werkende.
With additional housing in place, even more villagers could join the workforce. But a populous village would soon exhaust the natural food sources. To grow, the community needed dedicated farms.
Workende. Kende.
Kira.
Ah.
Kende. Yeah, the Earth Talenda.
Woodsmen and farmers now kept the village well supplied. Further growth required knowing the countryside and finding more resources. For that, communities employed scouts. Able to move quickly and see great distances, scouts were key to discovering new resources. The most important thing for a scout to locate was a ready source of gold.
Riedera. Yeherende. Yes, sir. Kande. Yes, sir. Kuthlich. Asteriende. Yeah, yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah, herende. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yes, sir. Asteriende. Ridende. Gande. Yeah, yeah. Asteriende. Yes, sir. Kuthlich. Ridende. Yeah, yeah. Kuthlich. Yes, sir. Ridende. Yes, sir.
To prevent having to haul ore large distances, expanding communities would establish a mining camp near the source of gold. well-placed camp ensured efficient gold mining.
Cheer, Las Abidende. Off to Delphan.
With a good supply of gold, the village was becoming a large town. The signpost of this growth would be the construction of a large landmark.
Kende.
With the landmark in place, the once sleepy village announced itself as a thriving feudal township. The townsfolk had been driven from their homes before, however. This time, they would defend themselves. The first step would be constructing a barracks for infantry.
Cheerless hair.
Here, Athopper. Each timber Theos.
Each a bluke that.
Once it had a barracks, the town could establish a standing force of soldiers. Simple infantrymen armed with spears were a common choice for these militias.
Yes, sir.
Act now. Garwigan, a wendende este ala. Ritnu.
The town now had a militia, and could look to reclaim the lands lost to invasion. The invaders had blocked the road north with a stout palisade. Although spears were of little use against these walls, the militia could burn down the obstacle with torches.
Garu Upa. Hora! Yerwath Garwigan.
On fondes trailum!
With the road open, the militia could now reclaim their lands in the north.
Astira, Garwigan.
First, the spearmen had to deal with a lone sentry.
Each will. Tremeth, Garu. Garwigan, Asetath. Garu Upa. Yes, sir?
Advancing aggressively,
Garu,
the militia eliminated the enemy sentry. The invaders had a small cavalry camp guarding the road, but the militia was ready to attack. Were highly effective against cavalry, allowing the militia to win the day. All that remained was to destroy the invaders' stables.
Thank you.
The invaders' cavalry post was destroyed, but other enemy positions awaited further up the road. Hostile archers defended the next camp, which would put spearmen at a disadvantage. The township needed cavalry of its own to deal with this, and so would need to build stables. To deploy that cavalry quickly, the town needed to build their stables near the front lines. Fortunately, friendly villagers came out of hiding and joined the effort.
Eat your work up! That shoulder built him, Brad!
With stables in place, the town could field horsemen of its own. The town now had a rapid light cavalry, skilled at harassing slower targets, such as archers.
You did it, Upa! Cheerless hands!
archery range burn to the ground, and the cavalry move to eliminate the last archers. The invaders' archers and their camp were destroyed. A final enemy emplacement remained, one fortified with palisades and defended by spearmen. To deal with this target, the town would need longbowmen. First, they needed to build archery ranges in the area regained from the invaders. Once more, friendly villagers arrive to help.
What the?
It's Timbratheos! It's a worker! That shoulder built him, Brad!
What's the faith there?
Off each a guy.
Fair and on.
Gone game they know.
Yeah!
And your worker. It's Timbratheos.
With several archery ranges in place, the town could add longbowmen to its forces.
And your worker. It's Timbratheos. It's a brookie, that.
and your work.
Yes, sir. Understood. Yes, sir. Where's the holler?
Shoot him, the Etos! It's been bad, the Volkova!
Yes, sir.
Where's the holler?
That should have been a template.
Okay, you miss it.
What's was shooting them?
Wendy
off. Here, Wendy off.
Wasting the shoot at it.
Nu, Yaras.
Leo da Hessa.
Tremeth Garu.
Aknawa.
Flamboga arod. Abuga strelboren.
A strong force of archers could eliminate enemy spearmen at a distance, so long as they took the proper position.
Estes comendei,
Strelboren Yerwa. Gath Strelboren.
Werniath. Vordoth.
Yeah, we have. Foliende, hear some.
Shayotende! Move!
Stand in faster!
Poised on a clifftop, the longbowmen would be protected from an infantry charge. The last of the invaders fell to the resurgent homegrown population. Now that their lands were free of enemies, the town could take the next step in its growth and become a powerful medieval city. Here too, the erection of a great landmark would be the signpost of this growth.
Yeah.